All right, here we are, game two between Team Red and Lincolns. We get a remake via all pick. We've got Baba Ganoush on the Marana, ASG on the Storm Spirit, Oscar with the Sand King, Love on the Shadow Demon, and Fuzzy Sloth with the Lifestealer. They smoke up. Smoked up as well is Jenkins on this Rubick. So we take a look at both these teams. Not too much push from the side of Team Red. Let me take a look at where both teams will be at early game. Once Fuzzy Sloth kind of grabs himself an armlet, maybe we see Storm hit level 6. There's the Burrow Strike with the arrow. Easy first blood. Down goes Jenkins. And it's looking good for Lincolns already. So like I was saying, you know, you get yourself a level 6 Storm, armlet on Fuzzy Sloth, and all of a sudden things can start looking good for the side of Lincolns, make it a little bit harder for Team Red. Team Red, they are almost going to get a courier kill. Not going to grab that bounty rune. Still doesn't say in-game. Thank you, Dota. We will be underway in all these lanes. Fuzzy Sloth up top against Monster, who's in this off lane as the Batrider. Only has Firefly for now. No sticky napalm just yet, but he's going to pull that creep wave and let his creeps go under tower. Meanwhile, mid, it'll be Bloody Nine up against ASG. And we take a look at this Enigma Ryu, who's got himself his demonic conversion. So he's got the Eidolons ready. Level 1, he'll be jungling. Oscar's down here with Baba Ganoush, as well as Love, while Jenkins is the Rubick down here with Annihilate. So, like I was saying early on, Storm and Lifestealer could be a pretty good pickoff combo. Once the Lifestealer hits level 6, has the Infest, has his armlet, you know, he can Infest into the Storm Spirit. They zip in, Infest bomb, pop it out, and then they find themselves a couple of kills with the Electric Vortex and all. Meanwhile, down low, Baba Ganoush gets a kill on Annihilate. Guess they line up the Burrow Strike as well as the Arrow and the Disruption. That's an easy kill going the way of Lincolns, and this time around, they're doing pretty well. So Love might come over here with the Disruption, try and mess up the farm of Ryu. If anything, that'll be what he needs. And Ryu's going to come over here. He's got his Eidolons doing work. The arrow comes through, and it will steal that creep away from Ryu on this Enigma. So he's got to know now it's either warded or he's under vision. And he's going to know now that this jungling is going to be very hard for him as the Enigma. Moving forward is Bloody Nine. ASG going to eat that Fairy Fire. A couple more hits and he will go down. Jenkins eats it to the tower as ASG does work and gets the kill. Bloody Nine now is going to be the one in trouble. There's the Disruption. Illusory Orb forward, and now the Shadow Poison is going to hit on Bloody Nine. He's going to eat that Happy Tree with the Tango. So Tango and Branch are used. And it's 3-0 for Lincolns as they are looking way better than they were in game one. So ASG using that static remnant to his advantage up against that Rubick, and Rubick eats it to the tower, and it gets pretty bad for the side of Team Red early on. There's the Disruption. Gonna push Jenkins back. He's gonna eat some pot shots from his own illusions. And we take a look over at Annihilate, who is 4-1 and in a bit of trouble down low as he's already been killed once and not having an easy time. There's the Burrow Strike right out on Annihilate. Now he's at half health. He could be in trouble if he doesn't back up and use that salve, and he'll immediately do so. We take a look up top. Baba Ganoush is here with Fuzzy Sloth, who's looking for that quick level 6 and armlet. If they can line up a couple of kills, it will become a bit of trouble here for the side of Team Red early against that Zip of Storm, as well as the Infest. They're gonna pull these creeps again. They've got a stack, and Monster is gonna look to take it. Baba Ganoush does not have Star Storm, in fact, so he's gonna try and just clear out a couple while they eat it to the Firefly. Meanwhile, Ryu in the enemy jungle. Gonna smoke up, head towards mid, maybe look for a kill. He's gonna be spotted by ASG, who is not level 6. There's the Malphus. And now the Illusory Orb comes in, avoided with the disruption. So saving the day right now is Love, and Ryu is gonna be the one who's in trouble as he backs out, and Baba Ganoush comes in to put a little damage in on the side of Team Red. So Oscar, not enough for a Burrow Strike. Not too sure he wants to be too deep in on this tower. Annihilate is here, not level 6 just yet. Take a look over mid. Shrine is used, and Arrow will get Baba Ganoush some farm as they heal up ASG, Love, and Baba Ganoush on that shrine. Coming back mid now is ASG. He's going to use that Static Remnant, find himself more last hits, more farm, just about level 6, and that's what they want. Is an early level 6 on this Storm. Denied. If they could get an early level 6 on this Storm, maybe they can move down. Ooh, actually, he's got the level 6 Static Remnant immediately, and ASG will find himself yet another kill. Sorry, that was not Static Remnant coming out. There's the Static Remnant with the slow. Double damage, zipping in. One more shot. Oh, just enough from the bottle. Woof. Here comes Annihilate. No mana left on ASG. He's got to run away. There's the dust. ASG, gonna use those illusions. And now Annihilate might be the one who's in trouble. He's dusted up. Coming in is Baba Ganoush. But they will not hit that arrow, but ASG will survive. It's just the ball lightning into overload. Charge. Overload? Charge? Charge? Overload? I got them confused for a second. Excuse me. So now, Storm level 7. Not much good's happening to Radiant's bottom tower. Let me take a look up top at Fuzzy Sloth. He's level 7, and the quicker he gets this armlet, the quicker Lincolns will have an easier time at picking off a lot of these heroes on the side of Team Red. Team Red can definitely be in a lot of trouble early on in this game. Ryu's just about level 6. He's going to be looking for that black hole, but it'll have to be really good for him to kind of turn this game around early on. So what's coming in? Clarity as well as a bottle. All right. So Ryu, why... Oh, I had to restart Dota, that's why it's not on. There we go. No more edge pan. Ryu does have that black hole. Not too sure he's going to waste it on just Fuzzy Sloth at the moment. Bloody 9, he's going to spot ASG, pop that clarity, but coming under is Love. So now there's the ball lightning, gets himself an arcane rune. Bloody 9 continuing to move forward. That may not be the right choice, but in is coming Monster. There's the courier. There is the dream coil with the illusory orb as well as the lasso. We'll break that dream coil and he will fall. But meanwhile, they're going to lose their puck, Oscar. As well as ASG in a little bit of trouble. Here comes Annihilate. Oscar He's going to get hit by Annihilate, but it's not going to be enough. There's the Burrow Strike. There's the Dust with the Disruption. Can they find an arrow with the Ball Lightning in? Is ASG is going to use that Time Lapse. Let's see. Arrow, no, in front of the mark. So now Annihilate still has to run away, but there's the Burrow Strike, and they'll get the kill anyway. So 6-1 in favor of Lincolns, and it's a complete turnaround on their performance from last game, which is very good for them, as they have gotten themselves 6 kills this game, doubling the amount they got last game already. So Disrupted is Bloody Nine again. Now he's going to try and move forward with that Illusory Orb, and will do so at about half health. Annihilate's coming through, maybe going to try and get a kill on ASG, but he's just going to harass him out. So there's really not much he can do under tower.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Meanwhile, Fuzzy Sloth just hitting away at this top tier 1. Getting ever so close to that armlet, which is what they need on the side of Lincolns to start zipping with the infest. So Baby Knight, or not Baby Knight, sorry, Baba Ganoush. Read that as Baby Knight. There's the arrow with the lasso coming out. Black Hole is used by Ryu on 2, but here comes the Storm Spirit. We'll get the kill on to Ryu. Now they move in on Monster. The Moonlight Shadow is there. There's the Fable with the Telekinesis. They're moving in. They've already got the kill on Baba Ganoush as well as Oscar, not Baby Knight. Not sure why that name popped into my head. Guess it looks similar. Baba Ganoush, Baby Knight. Not really. It's not even that late, so I have no excuses. Illusory Orb forward, down to the low ground. ASG going to zip forward. Now the Silence with the Dream Coil. He's going to pull him in. Bloody Nine in trouble. Static Remnant and the Overload will get the kill. Now they pop that lasso. He's going to be able to Ball Lightning into the high ground, and they won't be able to catch ASG anymore as he's already 6-0. Really demolishing the side of Team Red.
Dire's middle tower isn't going to last long.
So this is stacked up. ASG having an easy time with the Overload and the Electric Vortex, or not the Electric Vortex, and the Static Remnant. Shift this over to the net worth, and he does lead by 1,000. Next is the Lifestealer. So they will deny that bottom tower. Armlet on the way to Lifestealer, and with that, we might see a lot of movement come out from Lincolns. ASG does have this double damage. They might look to go in on the side of Team Red, especially if Fuzzy Sloth comes over and infests. They're already coming over. Monster is here. He's going to get spotted by Love, looking for the Disruption. He's going to Ball Lightning in. Now he's got the Electric Vortex. Monster getting very low. There's the Dust Annihilate in a bit of trouble, and now they're going to disrupt this Rubick. Rubick's going to get very low, but he's stolen Ball Lightning. He's going to get out. Wow. So they do Moonlight Shadow. They're looking for Annihilate. Hoshikuchi down towards tower. The Infest comes out. Annihilate going to try and salve up. He gets hit, so that's going to break. And Jenkins gets out with the Ball Lightning that he steals from ASG. And he still has it. So here comes Monster, ward placed down. They've got the Sticky Napalm out. Flame Break, they're going to get the lasso out on Baba Ganoush, and he will fall easily. Now the Burrow Strike away. Dream Coil hits on Oscar. He's going to Sandstorm up. There is the silence, the waning rift, and Oscar is going to fall too. So it's a double kill for Monster. And a good return, couple of return kills for the side of Team Red. So, Veil is picked up for Bloody Nine. Now surrounded is Annihilate. He's going to use the Shikuchi to get away from Love. If he could just spot him, get the disruption. No. Looks like it was going to be close. They did have a lot of lockdown if they did land the disruption out on him. So, yet to see the ball lightning with Fuzzy Sloth. Surprised I am yet to see it. Especially with both of them having armlet and being over-leveled compared to the side of Team Red. Can find themselves a couple of good pickoffs, which would be nice. And now the Blink Dagger comes out for Monster. There it is. With the Moonlight Shadow, wow. Monster gonna get spotted. They zip all the way forward. There's the Electric Vortex with the Ball Lightning and the Static Remnant. He's gonna use Lasso. And the Infest comes out from Fuzzy Sloth as well as the Rage, and he'll fall. Now he's gonna Ball Lightning even further, and they're gonna grab themselves a kill on Annihilate. ASG has found his hero. Wow. Great movement from ASG. They get themselves two easy kills. Meanwhile, top, they've lost a tier 2. Oscar going to defend this tier 3. So the counter push is good from Team Red. That's what's going to keep them in it. Especially with how well ASG is doing. And the Lifestealer, who is 1-0, Fuzzy Sloth. Echo Saber, finally. Seen Echo Saber on a Lifestealer today. Stupendous. Or not. Okay. So he does want that courier. Pretty badly, in fact. So there's the Infest going into Baba Ganoush, looking for a kill on Ryu, but he's going to back off, and they will just see these Eidolons push forward. So they're just trying to catch someone out. If anybody creeps forward, Ryu would be the candidate for that. He's actually going up towards this creep wave. And now, if they could just spot him... He was in ward vision, so now they want to go around. Spot him out. There's the Soul Ring with the Electric Vortex. Infest pops out. Ryu's dead. It's as easy as that. So with that, they'll push the tier 2. No fear of a black hole coming in. And Team Red, they're going to have to rotate. They can't really just let this happen. They don't have a lot of damage to push this down quickly, but they should be able to take a tier 2 with some ease. And they'll actually just back off. So ASG's finished off that Bloodstone at 18 minutes in. Pretty quick speed, and then you've got Armlet Echo Saber for this Lifestealer already at level 14. We take a look at the other side. Ryu's level 12. Annihilate, he's only level 10. He's got himself that Dragon Lance. The Puck, Bloody 9. He's got Blink Veil. That's okay at level 12. Batrider is level 12, so they're doing all right. But they definitely are behind, and that behind is 2,000 net worth as well as 5,000 in experience. So they're over towards the Shrine of Lincolns. Oscar's going to get spotted out. He is huge bait right now. There's the blink in with the Veil Illusory Orb. Burrow Strike comes out on two. There's the Infest with the Disruption on the puck, but the arrow's not going to hit. Ryu's looking for that black hole. He's not going to use it. And now it looks as though Jenkins is going to get taken down. ASG continuing to move forward. He does have that Bloodstone charges. There's the Moonlight Shadow. They might try to get Monster, who does lasso up the Lifestealer. And now they're continuing to work as Monster's just trying to get away with that Firefly. It runs out. They're continuing to move forward. ASG is here. He's got that Bloodstone recharging him up with 14 Bloodstone charges. Arrowstone forward. It will land on Monster. And now Baba Ganoush with the urn. He gets the Starstorm. One more hit will do it. And they've taken out three. Meanwhile, Oscar did fall in the back end to Annihilate. So a 3-for-1 in favor of Lincolns. They're up 15-7. And this Han team has shown themselves to be quite a bit of trouble for this ex-Leviathan squad. They can continue to roll like this. It should be a pretty quick game and easy for them, and we should roll right into game three. Bloody Nine, he does spot out ASG. I'm not too sure that's the spot he really wants to be in. 15 Bloodstone charges and nobody else with him. There's the lasso. Arrow comes through. Not going to hit on anybody. They've lassoed him up to the high ground. There's the telekinesis with the fade bolt. But here comes ASG. Ryu, he's looking for that black hole. He will not get it on anybody except for Oscar. There's the Burrow Strike. And now Bloody Nine is in here with the Waning Rift. Illusory Orb comes on through. Baba Ganoush is going to fall. Meanwhile, they bring down Ryu. They're looking to grab more. Bloody Nine in a bit of trouble, but there's the Dream Coil on too. He's going to ball Lightning out of the Dream Coil, and now they continue to go in on Bloody Nine. He's going to phase shift for just a moment. There's the Waning Rift again, and in trouble now is the Lifestealer Fuzzy Sloth. He's taken out. They'll take out another one. ASG gets a kill on Bloody Nine, and he will deny himself as it's a full team wipe for Team Red. They take out the entire side of Lincolns. So they go in a little too far to save their support Shadow Demon. And it does end up costing them quite a bit. Take a look at ASG, plus 10 intelligence, as well as the 3 mana regen. Cut down to 11 Bloodstone charges. We take a look at the Lifestealer, Fuzzy Sloth. He's picked himself up 5 all stats and 25 damage. He's still got the Desolator soon, as well as the Armlet and the Echo Saber as they look to head towards Roche. Should be an easy defense if anybody comes their way, but it looks as though 3 are up top for the side of Team Red. And they're just going to look to push as nobody's really coming their way. There's the Illusory Orb forward. It will spot that this Roche is being done at about half health. They don't have Black Hole for another minute, so it'd be a hard engage if they do choose to go for it. But it looks as though Lincolns, they've decided against this. They back off. They've got the Infest in on ASG, so maybe they're trying to trick them into going in. They leave that Roche at half health, and they're standing by. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's So they're under Ward Vision. There's the blink forward with the Burrow Strike comes out. They will get this puck, and now they're looking for more. ASG tries to go in on Jenkins. They don't have Black Hole just yet, and now the Enigma is stunned. Here comes the Epicenter. It's going to fly through on Ryu, but he's going to get stunned up. Now a couple more shots should do it to kill down Oscar, and they will find themselves a kill as buying back is this puck. Stunned up is Love. He's trying to get out, but a little bit of a fable comes in from the Rubik, and they will get themselves another kill. Buddy, not in a bit of trouble, and he just bought back, so this could be a lot of trouble for him. They're going to steal the open wounds. Fuzzy Sloth in a bit of trouble. They've brought down Baba Ganoush, and they will bring down Fuzzy Sloth. This game is entirely turned around on the side of Team Lincolns, as Team Red are right back in it with that 4-for-1 trade, as well as this Roche. It looked as though Lincolns had a shot there. They didn't even have to use Black Hole, which is now up, and now they get the Aegis on Annihilate. They've brought themselves right back into this game as the net worth hits even, as well as the XP. Now ASG down to 12 charges. Whew. So it's a tough game for Lincolns. They look to have the lead there by quite a bit. And now they're just in a lot of trouble as they're sitting on their heels as the side of Team Red, who get themselves another kill, this time on Oscar, have got themselves quite a bit of a lead. So Fiverr here for the side of Team Red. They take that tower pretty quickly, and now they've got some time. They can push pretty well, especially with these Eidolons. They're going to look to take another tier 2, as only one remains in that mid lane. They're going to keep going. They want the rotations to come in. They've got Black Hole. They know they can be effective in a fight. Ooh, there's the blink in with the telekinesis. It's going to hit. He steals Burrow Strike. Now there comes the Dream Coil. Burrow Strike comes in from Jenkins. There's the Black Hole, but only on one. It's going to be on the toughest of the targets, though. ASG hitting away as Fuzzy Sloth. Ryu's already done his job, so he's going to fall. Buying back is ASG. They're moving forward. There's the Electric Vortex. It's going to hit on Jenkins. He's going to be the second one to fall on the side of Team Red. Arrow thrown into the rift, and it will not land on anybody. Annihilate, he's spotted out by ASG. They're going to bottle up, try and find him. Oscar moving forward, not going to spot Annihilate just yet. And it will be the end of that engagement. Maybe ASG is moving forward, slows down Monster. There are the drums. The last charge, and he will be able to find an escape. So 20-17 Lincolns, but if we take a look at the net worth, 3,000 in favor of Red, XP coming back down towards Lincolns' favor. And ASG's finished off that Orchid, so that buyback didn't really hurt him all too much. Zipping forward is ASG's got the Orchid coming in, Electric Vortex, Static Remnant, now it's not enough. And he is out of mana, so he might be in a little bit of trouble. Ryu, he's looking for the Malphite. If he could just land it on ASG, he'd be in a lot of trouble. There's the Epicenter, and there's the Burrow Strike. It will land on two, and now they're in trouble, but blinking in is Bloody Nine with the Waning Rift. Not going to be enough. They've lost two. Coming in is ASG. Bloody Nine trying to get away. There's the Electric Vortex. He's stunned up for just a moment. There's the Phase Shift. Burrow Strike too early, but they will still get the kill. So a 3-0, and it's back and forth and back and forth as Lincolns, this time they win the fight. So 23-17, Baba Ganoush now has Ags, ASG, back to 13 Bloodstone charges, and he is looking to find himself a Lincolns, which would be pretty nice.
Radiant's top tower has looked better.
So they go to push this top tier 2, they will fortify it. They do have the infest on ASG, Yules comes out for Oscar. Annihilates down low, just trying to push that tier 3 in, but they will lose their tier 2 top, and that's their second to last tier 2. They don't have enough to bring down this shrine just yet, as this tier 2 still stands. They're trying to bait out a rotation, and they're not going to find it from the side of Team Red. Fuzzy Sloth has to get out of there. He's spending too much time in ASG, and he's losing that opportunity to farm as he's now dropped down a third on the net worth lead. So Black Hole available. Here comes the smoke. Jenkins, Ryu, Bloody Nine, they're in. They're looking for ASG. Can they find him? Smoke is not going to pop, but they are very close to the side of Lincolns. Ryu, he just needs to find something. ASG is still farming away, getting a little bit greedy. There's the smoke breaking. ASG, he needs to get out of there. He's trying to find his way out. Malphus almost comes in. Whew. So they will use the Eidolons now to push this mid-tier 2, and then they can go for Shrines. Coming around the back, though, is Lincolns. They got to be careful on the side of Team Red. So let's see, they are going to go for the five-man smoke, and they're going to try and bring the heat to the side of Team Red. They just need this tier 2 bottom, so if they can find that the lane is open, they wouldn't mind just trying to take the tower.
Stupendous.
Oh, they get scanned. Perfect Radiant scan. They know they're over there. Bloody Nine, as well as Monster, are looking for a pickoff, and ASG doesn't have that Lincolns just yet. Again, Fuzzy Sloth has to get out of there as they push this tier 2 bottom. They'll look to push the tier 2 bottom, then get the shrine. Meanwhile, Team Red's making the right decision as they want to push mid and force the same situation. So they take the tier 2 and now they TP back, maybe looking to find something as their tier 2 is about to get taken. No glyph comes out. There it is. Now Love is trying to find someone on the back end. Zipping forward is ASG. Arrow thrown as well. Not going to hit. They need to watch out. This is a double damage on Annihilate. They are going to grab Baba Ganoush. So they grab Baba Ganoush, and without him, they're going to sit back a little bit on the side of Lincolns. They kind of want that double Star Storm, and they'll lose the first shrine here on Lincolns. They lose this top shrine to Annihilate, who had a rough time in this early game, but he's brought himself back with the Dragonlance, Lincolns, and now the Mjolnir, and he's looking for a BKB of his own. He's starting to become a huge problem for the side of Lincolns, and to me, they might have missed their timing. comes a five-man smoke coming in from Team Red. Guardian Greaves are out. Blink. Black Hole is up for Enigma. If they can find a couple, they can take a Rax, and that would be very devastating for the side of Lincolns. They show themselves just a bit. There's the lasso on Baba Ganoush. They're going to hit away at him. He's looking for the black hole. Ryu's not going to find it as he ball lightnings forward with the infest. Now they're trying to find something. Fuzzy Sloth in a bit of trouble. He's going to be the one who gets blacked. Hold, there's the epicenter coming through. Nobody dead just yet. Baba Ganoush is going to have to buy back. Oscar in a bit of trouble. There's the Dream Coil out on two. They're looking for more. The Uzi Orb thrown forward. Buddy Nine gets the Waning Rift on three. So now three to silence up on the side of Lincolns. They're trying to run away. Oscar is going to get hit very low. He's going to Burrow Strike get Buddy Nine, but he's not going to get a kill just yet. They've lost the Life Steward. They've lost ASG. And now Oscar is going to be the next one to go. Ooh, or not. All right. Caster's curse there for me. My apologies, Oscar. I thought you were dead to rights. You proved me wrong. Now with the two cores dead on the side of Lincolns, it's going to be an easy tower and Rax for the side of Team Red. Here comes the blink in with the Burrow Strike on three. Oscar in a little bit of trouble. There's a Starstorm, but it's not going to be enough. He gets used up, and he is going to get very close to falling. Disruption this time around. Oscar is a man who is not wanting to die, but finally, Annihilate will get the kill. Now, Lub is in a bit of trouble, but there is the ball lightning through with the Waning Rift. Lincolns is popped. He's used up. He might be in a little bit of trouble. Baba Ganoush is trying to get back. There's a Dream Coil on, too, as well as the Disruption and the Lasso ASG. He's getting very low. Annihilate finds another kill this time on Lub. So they do take a set of racks in the mid lane, and ASG gets out with his life. But it is really hard for him right now. The game has become very hard as they're down 6,000, what should be more than 6,000 net worth. And now the XP is waving in the favor of Team Red. So what was a lead the entire game for Lincolns has turned into a step away from losing. It's the side of Team Red. They go for Roche, and they'll probably look to re-engage after this Roche is taken, especially with Black Hole off cooldown in just a moment. They've taken this Rax, they look up top, Bloody Nine's going to push top and really look for another set of a tower and Rax. The rest of his team has kind of just backed off for now as the Dagon is finished for Bloody Nine and Hurricane Pike is finished for this Batrider. Annihilate going for the Bloodthorn, he's about 600 gold away, so they'll probably just wait for that. And there it is. And Ryu's a click away from this BKB, and that's going to make it ever so hard for him to get popped out of that black hole. There's the Dream Coil coming through. Love will fall. That's Lasso and Dream Coil, but Dream Coil is only down for a minute, so nothing too crazy. They'll look to continue to put the pressure on Team Lincolns. Good TP to the Shrine. But it looks as though they're just going to farm and hold their aggression for a little bit longer. So ASG, who was once top of the net worth and really destroying this game, now 14-3, 8 charges left on that Bloodstone, and kind of looking for answers on the side of Team Lincolns against Team Red. Over on this Lifestealer has Basher looking for the Abyssal Blade to lock down one of the heroes on the side of Team Red. As the side of Team Red, they look to take this shrine, and they will take it with ease as Annihilate takes it down quite quickly. Oh. There's a double damage. He now hits for 450, and with that, they'll definitely move in on this bottom set of racks. Baba Ganoush, double Starstorm, going to clear up the creep wave, so not too bad, but Annihilate with that double damage is going to continue to take that tower. Not too sure they want to move in on this just yet. ASG standing to the side, looking for something. Again, they do not want to go in on Annihilate. There's the zip all the way past. They get the silence out on the Bloodseeker, on the Batrider. Again, I say Bloodseeker, but there's the black hole on the two. Oscar comes in with the epicenter, not going to bring anybody down just yet. There's the buyback on two from both the Lifestealer and the Storm Spirit. They take another one down in Oscar, and he'll buy back as well. Baba Ganoush is going to fall. Annihilate might finally go down, but that's just the Aegis. Baba Ganoush can't buy back as he's dead for 60 seconds, and already used their black hole, but maybe they look to just keep the aggression on. Moving in ASG, there's the Burrow Strike coming out on Buddy 9. Buddy 9 getting very low. ASG's gonna fall. That's 90 seconds on the sideline with no buyback. And now they're looking for something. Fuzzy Sloth is gonna infest. Now there's the phase shift as Buddy 9 still trying to avoid the side of Lincoln's. Fuzzy Sloth is gonna be the next one to go down. He's got no buyback. Dead for 95 seconds. And down will go Oscar, and GG is called. Just like that, Team Red, they take this series 2-0, and Lincoln's is eliminated from this closed qualifier. So the finals tomorrow is going to be Team Lincoln's versus, or not Team Lincoln's, is going to be Red Team versus Alpha Pro. We'll be back with that tomorrow at 9-ish, 6-ish, 9-ish. I'll type it in chat in a second. But we'll be back at that tomorrow. That's it for me tonight as Team Red take an easy victory 2-0. Thank you guys for watching. I am your caster, B-Cop, at B-Cop92 on Twitter. And that's it. Again, thanks for watching.